They ask it to me what means be a pro player or a pro team. I think that there aren't like some rules regarding that. It's more like, we can say also some kind of lifestyle, because there isn't a line, like I said, for be a pro or not a pro. It's how you think, how you act, how much training do you have. For be a pro player, it's not only what you do on the field, but also about how you think in general, what kind of attitude do you have with people, with your teammates, on the tournament, inside and outside the field. And more in details, for be a pro team, it's a little like the same. It's not only how much training you do together, but how you do it. It's for me more about mentality. If you are a pro, it's because you wanna do the things in the best way. Of course, for have only one goal, win. About our game, third game in the preliminary group against Ramstein Instinct. It was nice game, we won. In the beginning we were down 2-0 for them, but we were able to change something for our game plan and some move on the field, and it was of course much better after. That's why in the end, of course, we won. It was also a nice game for us because we played against Shime, that it was our ex-teammates from Scorpions, and he joined that team for that season, so it was also funny for that. And yeah, it was one game in particular, not super good, that we lost 3-5, but in the end, like I said, it was good, and all the change that we did it good, because pay out in the end. So it was good game. It was also a little bit not stressful, because we had like a good brain before the game for fix everything, because we lost against Impact the first game and we won the second one, so we had to win that game for be sure to play on Sunday, and we did it, so it was good, it was good.
And the ball. basket. Men han ställde sig upp i backen och så gick. Så va, men han springer upp hela vägen. Sen kommer det jävla ut. Så.
If I was not able to go to a tournament, I had to do something more important. Don't know what that could be, but not really that much you could do. I would, of course, try to help as much as possible with the preparations. I know all of the guys really well, so I know which buttons to push. I would try to talk to them and, you know, get their minds ready for the game. But I think if I was not able to be there for the event, you know, I would try to do as much as possible before the game, before the event, because we all know that preparation is a big deal in these tournaments. As long as we can play and practice the layout and play tournaments at the layout before, so I would try to help out as much as possible with the preparation, I think, and make them ready for the game.
Like the second family, regular family that you're born into, and then you have a family that you spare your almost more time than your regular family with. You go around the world, meeting new people and everything. It means a lot to me, basically everything. Everything to me. It was my first family that I got outside my own family. My own family back home, my mom and dad, but the team built me to who I am today. It learned me how to be a winner.
Pro player and pro division, I don't know, it's I think we shouldn't have pro. We shouldn't use the word pro, because there is no pro in paintball. There's not enough, not to sound negative, but there are no pros in paintball. There are 5 to 10 players in the world that gets paid to play, and they make an okay salary playing. So it's very hard to be professional paintball players. I was a professional paintball player for 10 years, I would say, and it didn't make me very rich. But being in the top division, it's like you really have to be super dedicated, because you're gonna put down a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of money, and you're not gonna get much in return except for that fantastic and awesome feeling you get from playing a paintball game and hanging out with your team. So I would say it's a it's more of a hobby paintball that you do to get away from your everyday life. And by saying this, with this said, I would also like to say that to all of you guys, it's so important that you really find a team. And if you're on a team, make sure that your team is having a good time when you do this, because this is your life. You're putting down so much time, work and money on this, so make sure you get the most out of it. Make sure you have a good team chemistry and really work on that, because that's like one of the most important things. And when you get that down, when you get the good team chemistry and you have a lot of fun, you're also going to win a lot more, because you're going to love who you're playing with next to on the field. And to me, that's probably one of the most important things. Like, and I've been lucky, like I have always had this inner feeling like that if I played on a team or if I was in a position that I didn't like, I always went to the next thing. I didn't escape, but I felt inside that this is not right. This is not making me happy by being the person that the best person I can be. You know, if I'm still the best person I can be and I communicate my inner thoughts and so on, but I still cannot affect the negative position that I'm in, that's, you know, where when I took off and went to the next thing, which hasn't been a lot of times, because I've been fortunate enough to be on really, really good teams like Joy Division, New York Ground Zero, Russian Legion. Was okay chemistry, very professional, very good team, gave me an opportunity to play American events for free and get paid doing it, but it wasn't for me. It wasn't like, it was more like a machine at the time. I don't know how it is now, but so I played two tournaments with them and that's it. That's pretty much the only team that I left that I didn't guess play for. So yeah, us Milano Scorpions, of course. I don't know what I was thinking. Great team.
The gun, the Clone 5S, is absolutely amazing to shoot. Clone 5 was also very good. Clone 5S, big difference I think is it's more reliable, less requirement for lubrication and service. It shoots the most brittle paint, no doubt about it. Other guns can't shoot the paint we can shoot, so luckily we can, and we get super fragile and good paint, and we have absolutely no problems with it. We love the guns. Whenever there is a problem or we need some tech support, or if we're just lazy and want them to do the job for us with lubing the guns and stuff, we have the great support at the events always, and so we are very, very happy with our core. With teaming up with MacDev in Australia and also with the European division and the support.
We knew about the Taunton game, it's gonna be a tough game. We scouted it pretty well. You know, they were strong at the center. Usually use like two guys up in the front. No, Axel is pretty tough on the snake side, and they have Monty Mayer on the Dorito side. But still, we couldn't manage to hold them back. I don't know what made the difference between them. They pretty beat us pretty hard. The difference was maybe the lack of the experience of the main parts of the team. Sadly, we miss a coach right now, so that makes obviously a big difference. We will try to fix that for the next event. But, still, we need to get in the game harder and better for the next event.